Howdy and welcome. You are listening to A Mom's Guide to Wine, a guided wine tasting with candid reflections on motherhood. Here we spill the tea, but never the wine. We're your hosts, Eliza James
and Rosie Gold,
and we are so glad you joined us for today's tasting adventure.
As always, full disclosure, for those with little ears around, 90% of our topics and language will be more on the R rating scale. Also, we are not professionals nor experts. We are simply sharing our experiences and including some Google searches for support. We are amateur wine enthusiasts and professional moms. That is our skill set.
But first, the wine.
Of course, it's going to be a doozy.
It's a doozy. Today's wine is the Stella Rosa Pineapple and Chili Prestige. You heard it. Chili. We're having chili wine.
Because why not?
This one in particular is a white wine, so we have it chilling. But a little bit about Stella Rosa is the Riboli family. This is the founder of the Riboli Wine Estates and the creators of the Stella Rosa. And it started back in 1917 when the Riboli family founded a Los Angeles historic San Antonio winery. Back then in Los Angeles, it was the prime location for wine growing in all of California. And for some time, the wine industry reigned as one of Southern California's most economically significant and, like, popular industries of all time. They survived Prohibition, so that was a big deal. And then about a century later, they still continue making their wine. So that's kind of cool.
And now they add chilies.
You can go to the San Antonio Winery, not San Antonio, Texas. I was a little disappointed. San Antonio, California. And you can try their lighter, more light and refreshing wines. They made the semi-sweets, the Diastis.
Oh, yeah. It's like D'ASTI.
Yes. So
I do know I like those.
That is their flagship line, is their Diastis. So most of their wines are going to be on the sweeter side. I've not had any of their wines that are not on the sweet side. I just want to throw that out there. And their wines are usually on the more affordable range. Most of their wines are $10 and under. They're kind of like the bare... I think of them as the same line as the Barefoot, right? Like, they're really good wines. They're just not expensive. And so I really like them. They boast over 20 distinctive flavors. Bam. Now you know a little bit about the Stella Rosa winery. But I think they import all of their wine. It is not made in California. I think that's just where they bottle it these days. For some reason, I was led to believe that they do a lot of importing from Italy.
Okay.
Could be wrong. Go to the website and check yourselves. But I believe that is what they do. So, we're going to open this bottle. It's a twist top. We're going to pull it out of the ice real quick. Yeah, it's dripping. Alright, so
humidity.
I know, right?
Don't they know it's winter? It's not supposed to be humid.
It says this is a semi-sweet. I'm just worried it's going to be spicy. I'm not even going to lie. I brought, because cheese went so well with last episode that I thought, let's do it again. It was fun. But I bought a very soft cheese because I'm hoping it'll coat the palate if this is spicy.
And we also have bread in case we choke.
Yeah, we also have bread, but that's like our backup.
Surely, you know, with how long they've been in business, their goal is not to burn us.
Yeah.
So
it's a very pretty bottle. It's just a white bottle with black labeling and bright orange, what do you call that? Like
orange and burgundy.
Yeah. Like lettering. It's real pretty.
And the crown, which I believe is the Stella Rosa sign.
Yes.
Symbol.
And this is considered a low alcohol content. It's only 5%.
Okay. See, they don't want to burn us.
No. Mm-mm. It says
maybe
here,
it's compensating for the chilies.
It says here on the label, grapes of our delicious Stella Rosa Pineapple and Chili Prestige are harvested from beautiful vineyards. That's all they tell you. A refreshing wine combined with natural flavors of pineapple, surprise, and chili. Also, surprise.
Both are pictured on the label. Talked about multiple times. Right.
This is to serve with chilled fresh fruit, cheese, spicy cuisine, and dessert. So I guess if you want to add some spice to your spice, you could drink this.
Or Taco Tuesday.
I was thinking this might be good with, like, cheesecake. Hear me out.
Okay.
Cheesecake. I drink, a friend of mine, she goes by Kool-Aid in the Derby world. She introduced me to spiced rum and cheesecake. And so when I think of things that are spicy and flavorful, I think cheesecake.
I just think cheesecake.
You're like, I was down for the cheesecake.
I just think dessert.
It's only 110 calories a serving.
And it says it's more sweet.
And since there's five servings.
A sweeter wine.
All right, here we go. I'm going to open
it. We shall see.
You want to grab glasses?
Yes.
All right. Well, I said I was going to open it.
Just a twist top.
There we go. Bam.
And we're in.
Dun, da, da, da. So on the website, it says it's for featuring a proprietary blend produced from mostly Moscato grapes with hints of the Italian chili peppers. It says it should spice up any occasion. Handcrafted, countryside, Italian vineyard, semi-sweet, semi-sparkling wine is best served chilled or mixed with your favorite spirit. So it says it could work for spicy margaritas. That was kind of cool. I do love a good margarita. I still think it's funny that in the under the flavor profile, they just wrote ripe pineapple and spicy notes of chili.
I wonder if they just literally throw pineapples and chilies in the barrels.
I just
strain it later.
Well, you know, most places are like, you'll get hints of oak or whatever. You know, like, you get some, they're just pineapple and chili. That's it. It's all
it
you get.
It smells.
It is bubbly.
It smells like, sweet.
You can hear it. Listen.
Very bubbly.
Which I'm surprised. It is very bubbly.
I think I smelled the chilies. I'm sorry.
Did you try?
Oh, I stuck my nose way down here after the bubbles happened.
Yeah, don't do that. Don't sniff it.
It was great to sniff before the bubbles. It was a very sweet smell. I did smell a little pineapple.
That chili and the bubbles.
But then you make
eat
the
you.
Bubbles, and then the bubbles are like, hey, let's bring the chilies to the top.
They burn your nostrils. I haven't even put it in my mouth.
All right, let's try it. Let's try it.
I'm not going to breathe while I do this. Okay. It is not spicy at all.
I like it a lot.
Like, I'm waiting for the chili. You can smell it, but I don't taste it.
I like it.
It's just, actually, it doesn't even really taste a whole lot like pineapple.
I'm tasting pineapple.
Well, I mean, I can taste the pineapple,
but I feel full-flavor pineapple.
I know, it tastes more... It's got, like, a little...
It's definitely not spicy,
cantaloupe,
like
hint to it. Like, I feel like there's some other fruit blend in there.
Maybe.
I mean, they say it's just pineapple, so obviously it's just pineapple.
I taste pineapple.
I mean, there's pineapple. But, oh, cheese!
Test it out. Oh, it's a very soft cheese.
I told you, because I was worried about being spicy.
I saw a limp noodle in my hand.
You got a noodle of cheese. Oh, that's pretty good. Take a bite of cheese, take a sip of wine. Yeah, that's pretty good. That's pretty good. It's not as epic as the last one we did, but this is pretty good.
Yeah, this one's pretty good. I like it.
Yeah. Oh, the cheese is special. Hold on. I brought the label with me this time. Because I thought last time I felt really dumb being like, oh, it's whiskey. This is called the Port Salut. And so on here it says the aging takes 1 month, during which time the cheese is brushed in brine, promoting the growth of a stinky bacteria.
Ugh.
That makes it... Yeah.
It doesn't, as I put it in my mouth.
But it doesn't smell. Like, I thought
but
it was going
to
smell.
Why does it say brine and bacteria?
But it doesn't smell at all. It doesn't have an odor at all. I just want to be clear on that. It makes it achingly rich. Well, I agree. It's very rich flavored and ever so slightly pungent. But I guess that they're talking about the mouth feel, like it tastes pungent more than, because it does not smell pungent.
No.
It says it's fruited with notes of cream, a bit of bite to balance the mellow flavor. And it boasts a pale yellow interior and edible bright orange rind, which it's not the butt, it's the rind. I've learned something today. I'm not eating the butt well, reading
some
rhyme.
Some of it you can eat and some of it you can't.
And it says it's from pasteurized cow milk. There we go.
Very nice.
So I thought that was kind of fun.
So they add the bacteria to the pasteurized milk.
Yep. Oh,
got it.
Yeah, to make a stinky cheese, which is not stinky, but it definitely has a tang to it.
This wine, you can feel, you don't really feel the alcohol.
It doesn't taste like alcohol. It tastes like a fruit drink.
Yeah.
Which this would be really good as a mix for a cocktail. They're probably right. They say on here that you could have it with like elote. I think that would be good. I could go for some elote, but I'm just hungry, so that's a different story for another day. I'm just going to have to pace myself.
On season 3, full of chaos, what are we talking about?
Toddler tantrums.
Of course.
Because we've all had them.
What else is chaos?
Yeah.
What is more chaotic about family life than thinking about the toddler tantrum?
Right. And I just want to...
Are our kids still toddlers?
No.
They're not. What are they?
Preschool.
Mm.
I had
questions. You can't get into preschool.
Yeah, you can't get into preschool, but I Googled it because I was like, are they toddlers? Because, so, toddlerhood is defined from 2 to 3. Once they reach 4, they're considered preschool age, which makes me think of them as like a tyke. Like a little tyke.
A tyke? Yeah. Like a tyke bike?
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, this is exactly where my mind went to. I was like, oh,
we're
doing
a lot of rhyming so far, so we're ready for preschool.
Oh, yeah. We're ready. Ready, yo. Drop some rhymes. Throw some lyrics.
I wish. No, I'm not that good.
So
I can't remember Twinkle Twinkle Little Star and I throw random lyrics.
Have you ever played the Why Is My Toddler Mad Today game?
Absolutely not.
No?
Because he's mad every day about everything.
All right, good point. So
what's the game?
So people have started this trend online where they go... online and they go, guess why my toddler's mad today? Oh, because I wouldn't let him eat the apple slice that fell in the mud and I threw it away.
Oh, that's cute.
And so, and then you're supposed to comment with why your toddler was mad today. And so it just, it creates like a list, you know, of people complaining about why is my toddler mad today? And mine was, my toddler was mad because I said he could have his tablet, but he wanted the tablet and something else. And I didn't give them to him in the right order. So that's why he's mad today.
You know what? He don't get no tablet.
That's why he's mad. So I told him, I was like, fine, can't have the tablet. Well, I don't want the tablet. I'm great. You know what? Nobody cares. Nobody cares. I learned very recently that...
go find something else to play with.
To get my my son really upset is just tell him you're taking him to the doctor. That'll do it. That's super traumatizing, apparently, for him. And if you mention taking him to the doctor, he goes, I don't need to go to the doctor. And you're like, yes,
maybe
you do.
Maybe you should go more often and maybe it'd help.
We go all the time. I think that's the problem.
Oh.
We go too often. He's always sick. So
I know if you have a dog that's angry. Like, I have an angry dog. And if he's angry, they recommend you take them to the vet more often to make it less angry. And it doesn't work for him.
Yeah. Well,
my dog is still an angry dog.
He's just born that way. He can't help it.
Anyway, back to toddlers.
Yeah, you can literally find anything to why a toddler can be upset, right? Like, you didn't cut the sandwich into squares. You cut it into triangles. Or you didn't fold it the right way.
Or you opened the banana instead of just handing them the banana.
And they wanted to open it themselves. And then it broke. Oh, my God.
Mine is very much that style. Like, anything that's unexpected that he expected to happen, like, it's
not okay.
Full down meltdown.
Yeah. So that's how you play Why Is My Toddler Mad Today game. And they can literally throw a temper tantrum about anything. Kids are really good about that. I was thinking, yesterday. Now, mind you, we obviously don't have toddlers anymore, but we still deal with the temper tantrums. But ours was over. His shoes didn't feel fine on his feet.
Aw.
He says his shoes, his feet want to have fun, and his shoes were not making his feet feel fun, and he didn't want to wear them. And so we had a fit because you have to put on your shoes to go to school.
We mentioned we live in Texas, and my kiddo, who's 4 and a half, he was going around 2 days ago kicking cactus. And I kept telling him, you're going to kick those cactus, and the thorns are going to go in your boots. And he ignored me and said, no, it won't, because he's rude like that. And I said, okay, I'm just...